this is my Wrestle Kingdom 3 review, and it's finally come. The reason why I didn't do it earlier was because I'd watched it via stream, and then had to get around to watching it again on DVD. It took me too long, and then I'd forgotten what happened when I'd watched it on stream, or you know, on the internet. So I had to watch it again to do this review, and because I'm so far behind in all my DVDs that I've got to watch, that it's only coming now. Best matchup: Mystico, Raisuke, Taguchi, and Prince Devitt. I had trouble before pronouncing Taguchi's name. Versus Averno, Jado, and Guido. This match was just a standard fun opener, high paced, lots of big spots. Well, big for an opening match. Mystico only really worked with Averno, obviously CMLL, or maybe Mystico wanted to be protected, not just physically from the other guys, but you know, in terms of how he looked in the ring. Averno, he's got lots of experience with him, and they've had some good matches with each other in CMLL in the past, as that's where they're from. That was CMLL's contribution to this card, so he wanted to obviously look good for his kind of debut, I guess. Mystico did lots of dives to the outside to Averno, which was fun. The crowd popped for it, and you know, the rest of the match was also pretty good, with Prince Devitt doing, I think, a dive to the outside, which was quite nifty. But yeah, the standard opener, lots of fun. Yay. Our next match was the Jushin Thunder Liger 20th anniversary match, with Jushin Liger and Takuma Sano versus Wataru Inoue and Koji Kanemoto. This match, much like the last one, was pretty good. All the guys being veterans, and the youngest one being Inoue, I believe. I think that's how you pronounce the name anyway. If I'm wrong, correct me, please, because I'm not going to learn unless you do correct me. But yeah, this match was a lot of fun, like the one before it. A bit slow in some bits, but you know, it was pretty good action, and I enjoyed it. There's not really much to say other than it was an enjoyable match, because it was a pretty standard tag match, but you know, fun. I don't know, I guess good match to celebrate the 20th anniversary of Jushin Liger, so 3 stars for that. Next match, we had the IWGP Junior Tag Team title match. Alex Shelley and Chris Sabin from TNA, or the Motor City Machine Guns, versus No Limit from New Japan. No Limit hadn't had the belts for very long before this event. I think maybe 2-4 months, maybe. I can't remember exactly. But this match was pretty good. I can't remember who it was. I think it was maybe Yujiro who jumped on Alex Shelley's face, gave him a blood nose. But yeah, this match was another good junior heavyweight match. This was a really fun match. Mostly Machine Guns and No Limit worked pretty well together. Yeah, I enjoyed the match. It was high-paced and fun. The crowd was obviously a bit dead for it because they weren't as familiar with Mostly Machine Guns as they would have been with other tag teams. But I think they got a bit more into it in the end, which was good, so 3.5 stars for that, I guess. Next we had the IWGP Junior Heavyweight title match between Tiger Mask 4 and Loki, which was an average match. It wasn't quite what I was expecting from them. The thing with Tiger Mask is sometimes I really enjoy his matches, sometimes it just seems bland and boring. This was one of those matches which just seemed bland and boring. They could have done a lot better with it. Some people enjoyed it. I didn't really enjoy it too much. The crowd got into it enough, and it was a bit too short for my liking. I thought it would have been a bit longer. Actually, it being a title match, so I don't know, about 2.25 stars for that. So yeah. Then we had the Fighting Holdings competition with the main event Mafia and Legends, with Masahiro Chono and Riki Choshu, as well as Kurt Angle and Kevin Nash, teaming up against Giant Bernard, Takashi Iizuka, Tomohiro Ishii, and Karl Anderson. This match, Kevin Nash did the best he could, obviously, by not staying in the ring for too long. Otherwise, he would have pulled his hammy or something, or torn his quad, or torn his bicep by moving. But yeah, he came in, took did some moves, got out of the way. That was the most you can ask of him. Ricky Choshu obviously got the biggest pop, and the crowd's quite dead for Kevin Nash and Kurt Angle, which goes to show Americans just can't show up and get pops anymore. But yeah, Ricky Choshu, I was really surprised that he got the biggest pop, and yeah, it was quite good. Quite good for what it was, so about 2.5 stars match. 2.5 stars for that. World Heavyweight Title Crusade for Justice match. Yuji Nagata versus Masato Tanaka for the 0-1 world title. This match was quite good and the crowd was really hot for it. Obviously, the 0-1 versus New Japan feud has been a highlight of New Japan, or was a highlight of New Japan over 2008, and this was really kind of, you know, some of the payoff of it. The crowd was very hot for the match. Masato Tanaka got a lot of heat. Yuji Nagata got, you know, big pops. But problem with I had with the match was it was a bit too short for my liking. Masato Tanaka bled, and that was pretty cool. It added to the match, I thought. So yeah, 3 stars for that. Good match, just a bit too short for my liking. And then we had New Japan vs. Noah Battle Tendencies, The Invasion. Jesus Christ, I have a lot of titles for these matches. I guess that was how they sold the card, with everything having a subtitle. John Akiyama and Manabu Nakanishi. The deal with this was they both were amateur wrestlers together. So, yeah, and it was one went to Old Japan, one went to New Japan, so this was kind of them coming full circle, I guess. This match was... there was nothing wrong with it. Akiyama got a big pop as a Noah guy. He got a bigger one than Nakanishi, so that's saying something. If the guy can't get a bigger pop than an outsider in his company's own flagship show. And that, the match was, it was just there, it was bland, I guess, but there was nothing really wrong with it. There was nothing where I was like, oh God, I can't stand this. I just sat there, watched and went, well, that wasn't very overwhelming. It wasn't underwhelming, but it was just there. I mean, not much. There's literally nothing I can say about the match, good or bad, so I don't know, like 2.5, I guess. Next match we had was the IWGP Tag Team Title match, and the Hardcore Rules. I found this match quite amusing for many reasons, Team 3D being in the match, one of them, versus, so it was Brother Ray and Brother Devon versus Hoji Makabe and Toru Yano. I guess my Australian accent makes me pronounce the Japanese names a bit differently, so I apologise for that. Don't cut my nuts off or anything. I found this match quite amusing because you had Team 3D who came out to no reaction, kind of get one gradually. Brother Devon obviously did all the work because he's the most fit of the two. Brother Ray did a lot less. Brother Ray basically got the crowd into it by clapping and doing all that stuff. Brother Devon doing all the work. But yeah, the crowd got into it. It just wasn't very spectacular. But you know, at least Team 3D used what they had from all their experience in wrestling to get the crowd into the match. Of course, the match quality wasn't the best. So yeah, 2 stars for that. Then we had New Japan vs. Noah Battle Tendencies, The Encounter, with Shinsuke Nakamura vs. Hiroki Goto vs. Misawa and Segura. Misawa and Segura got the bigger reaction here. I think Misawa and Choshu got the biggest reactions, as they are probably the biggest mainstream names on the show, I guess. But yeah, this is a really good match. Misawa actually worked hard for once. I mean, the problem with Misawa recently is he's too old to do really good singles matches, but in a tag match, he can usually do a lot better. And this was one of those matches where he could take a break, come back in. Segura did a lot of the work. Misawa, he was working really hard for it. Nakamura and Goto are both really good workers, and so they did as much as they could to get a good match out of them. I'll probably give it 4.25 stars. The crowd was really into it, and I was pretty into it. Even though you'd have to believe most of the fans would know that Misawa and Segura weren't winning. Then we had the IWGP Heavyweight Title match, Hiroshi Tanahashi versus Kenji Muto. There was nothing really amazing about this match for a main event. It was a good main event, don't get me wrong. I really enjoyed it, but there's not really much to say out besides that it was a enjoyable main event, and Kenji Muto holding the title for until this thing, everyone knew Hiroshi Tanahashi was going to win the belt on this night, as that was what the build had been with Kenji Muto holding the title. They built up this young guy to take over and win, and because of that, the crowd kind of got behind him. So the crowd got behind Hiroshi Tanahashi, which was good, because it's something that a lot of promotions say should take note of, putting the young guy over in a main event, and that's what they did here. It was a good match, 4 stars. Yay. My score for the pay-per-view, 8.25 out of 10, I guess. So, yeah, thanks for watching. Goodbye.